I'm living the dream. Hope you guys are all living yours as well. If you have not done so yet, please take a moment to like, share, and subscribe. Especially if you're new to the channel. If you are, welcome. We run with scissors. And if you're just same old people returning, keep running with scissors. That's just how it's going to work. So today I want to talk about autocorrect. It has definitely ruined our lives at some point. But sometimes it can be downright hilarious. And I found some of these. And I'm going to try to get through these. Because, guys, I find these to be hilarious. Like, I'll be, like, crying, laughing in the corner. So, I don't know. But, yeah, let's just jump right in. All right, this first one. Mike, are you definitely going to veterinarian school? Yep, I'll get to spend my days humping animals, and that makes me happy. Wow, helping. Definitely meant helping. I was so scared there for a second. Dude, seriously. If your job requires you to hump animals, you may want to find a new job. New career, new vision, new anything. But helping animals, that is a likely cause. Do not be bamboozled by the humping of animals. My God. You can be a sheep herder, you know, because they're known for that, which is a shame. This is Julian. How did Emily break her finger? Her finger got stuck in my butthole. What? Holy shit, my buckle, belt buckle. That is the funniest thing I have heard all day. That is the funniest thing I have heard all week, ma'am. I don't know how funny of things you're hearing all day or all week. Her finger had stuck in my butthole and it broke. There's so many questions after that. I mean, like, what exactly explains it? Why was her finger in your belt buckle, sir? Can we talk about that, my guy? Was she helping you buckle your pants or unbuckle them pants? Either way. Keep your finger out of buckles and buttholes, because it doesn't end well. Oh my God. Could you imagine getting that? That's the funny part to me. Yep. That's how it went down. I don't know what it is about this one. It cracks me up. So this is Babe. Mashed potato or bitch goblet potatoes tonight. What the fuck? Oh my God. Butthurt potatoes. Bitthurt. Ah! Buttered. Okay. First of all, what is a bitch goblet, period? Why would autocorrect jump in with that? Bitch goblet, is that a goblet that a bitch drinks from? And why would those be confused with potatoes? I'm really confused on bitch goblet at this point. Butthurt I get, bit hurt, still a little weird about that one. I don't know why they, like, how are these better alternatives? How is bitch goblet better than buttered in this autocorrect world? I don't understand. Maybe I will look up bitch goblet when I get out of here. Maybe it's a real thing. I don't know. Hey, where did you go? I'm just defecating outside. You want to come help? Everything's getting tangled. Ew, gross. You know we have a toilet in the house. Oh my God, haha, I'm decorating and the lights are tangled. Sure, ma'am. Sure. That's your story and you're sticking to it, huh? Okay. But yeah, that's not okay, dude. Like, if you autocorrect, for real, like, oh my God. Ugh, what? No, I don't want to come help. I do not wish to help. Thank you for asking. Thank you so much for asking. Oh, hold on, because this, I can't see this. All right, hold it now. Ooh, wait. I figured something out earlier. No, I guess I didn't. Okay. Well, we're just gonna swing it from here. I got your package in the mail. What is it? Blurry dick. Huh? Blu-ray disc. Autocorrect. What movie? An old favorite. Finding Nympho. You should stop texting for a while. Finding Memo. Finding Memo. Nemo. Dude, seriously, at some point, just give up. Like, just stop. You're not getting through. You're not getting through. Oh my god, Finding Nympho. That sounds like a classic, doesn't it? Debbie Does Dallas, Finding Nympho. Pretty sure you can find them both in the same section of the movie store. Not that there's movie stores anymore, it's all just blue or red box. Not that anybody has a DVD player anymore, or a Blu-ray, or any of that. Oh, the internet has ruined that. Are you packing a sweatshirt? Do you think we will need one? I'm bringing two. My camel toe is huge, so I'm just cramming as much in there as I can. My camel toe, oh my god, haha. That is the last straw with autocorrect. The straw that broke the camel toe's back? LMAO. Dude, that is too funny. Like, my camel toe is huge. And, I mean, some people's are, and that's, you know, who am I to judge? But, wow, don't stuff sweatshirts in your camel toe. Don't do it. Don't do that. It's going to be uncomfortable. And it's just going to make it bigger. Ugh. Hey, what are you up to? Just finished masturbating. It makes me feel so relaxed so I can go to sleep earlier. Or easier. Awkward. Shit, I meant menstruating. Not any less awkward. Oh my god, I meant meditating. What is wrong with this phone? And I agree. Why is masturbation or menstruation the first thing this phone goes to? And I know autocorrects are somewhat based off stuff you type. So it makes me think this person is typing a lot more about masturbation and menstruation than meditation. But to each their own. What do I know? But man, that's funny. Just imagine getting that text. Like, what? Too much. We're sharing a little too much. Oh. I am at Home Depot. Do you need more paint? Yeah, I probably need 2 more gallons. What color? I forgot the name. Bear 7708-7. Chocolate Shart. I just asked for that and the guy laughed at me for 5 minutes. Oh my god, it's Chocolate Sparkle. I am laughing my ass off. Sorry. Could you? Who? Okay. But honestly, Matt, you didn't put that through your head. Chocolate Shart is probably not a color of paint. I mean, maybe it should be, but probably not. Who comes into your... Oh, what a lovely color that you painted. What is that? Oh, it's Chocolate Shart. No, it's not. Chocolate Sparkle. Even Chocolate Sparkle sounds weird, but whatever. Not my halls, they're painting. Not my halls, they are painting. Oh my god, that's hilarious. Yes, fit the screen. I swear, it makes me crazy. Alright, whatever. Alright, next one. Alright. Are you doing the Nutcracker this year? Yep, I'm auctioning kids tomorrow. Suctioning kids. Ridiculous Auto Cat Rectal. Birdseed. I'm auditioning kids foreplay. Wow, I am sorry I asked. Dude. None of this went right. None of it. You're auctioning kids tomorrow. Not a good plan, but whatever. I feel it. Suctioning kids. Up the nose. We all had to do that. Ridiculous Auto Cat Rectal. Again, where? Birdseed. I'm sure that's supposed to be bullshit. But where do they get this idea? Ridiculous Autocorrect is what that's supposed to be. Ridiculous Auto Cat Rectal. You went from autocorrect to autocatrectal, which is not even a thing. It can't be a thing. It's not a thing. It's not. What in the hell? Oh my gosh. Oh. Hi, this is Randy. I saw your penis for sale on Craigslist. Is it still available? If so, I would like to come take it for a test drive tonight sometime. Hi, Randy. I'm selling a Prius. Is that what you meant? Yes, apologies, new phone. Well, it's Craigslist, so you never know. Dude, for sure. I could see that happening. Like, oh my god, this guy wants my penis. Not cool. But I guess it kind of depends on how hard up the money he is. You know, he might really consider that. If I can sell this penis for the same price as a Prius, bring it on, Donkey Kong. Bring it on. Okay. Yeah, I'm so horny right now. I'd eat a dong right now. Horny. Hungry for dong. Dong, not dong. Dog. Fridge auto cucumber. Fridge auto cucumber. I give up. Dude. Okay. So, pretty sure it's supposed to say, I'm so hungry, I'd eat a dog right now. But he's so horny, he'd eat a dong right now. And the fact that that fits together so perfectly is kind of shameful. Like, wow. And it's poor Rashad. They probably do eat dogs. But I'm hungry for dong. Dude, I'm dying over this one. Fridge auto cucumber. Again. Autocorrect, you will never see yourself as the enemy, will you? You know we're trying to say fuck autocorrect. You just keep cat rectals and fridge cucumbers right there. That's what we're always talking about. Oh, ridiculous. Just watch the news. Weatherman says to prepare for flamingos this weekend. Oh, God, no, anything but flamingos. Ha, flooding, this phone is so silly. That's a relief. I was unsure how to prepare for a bird invasion. Guys, I would welcome the flamingos. Bring it on home. Bring it on home, flamingos. But can you imagine watching the news and he's like, the flamingos are coming, man. Get yourself some shrimp because they're going to want them. Something. That's crazy. What did you do today, Mom? Clean, paid bills, made pasta. I just gave your father a huge boner and now he's passed out on the couch. Ew! Do not need to know that. Oh my goodness, I give him a huge bowl. I'm laughing out loud. I'm glad you are because I want to barf this poor mom and child. Oh, she just gave her father a huge boner. Dude, not okay. Didn't want to have that conversation. Still don't. Like, no. We're good on that. Oh my god. That's too funny. Dad and I fondled ourselves for the first time last night. We didn't get good results. Nothing came up. LMAO, Mom. I don't know what you tried to write, but that's hilarious. Damn autocorrect. Erect. Damn auto-erect. Not correct. Erect. Autocorrect. We Googled ourselves. No results. Oh, Mom, I'm dying of laughter. I would be too. Like, dude. So you have fondled yourselves for the first time, and nothing came up. Freaking auto-erect. Apparently that wasn't even working. Oh, that's great. But they were just Googling themselves. It was totally innocent. Nothing to see here. Move on. All right, and this last one, let's just get it in there. Great news, I finally found my G-spot. Wow. Thank you so much for sharing. Congratulations. I found it in the back seat of my car. Okay, Mom. Now this is just getting weird. I know we're close, but come on. Huh? Oh, God. My GPS. Dude, when your mom texts you about finding her G-spot, I mean, kudos to her for even responding because, you know, she's like, wow, Mom, great. Good job. Congratulations. Then she continues with this she found in the back seat of her car. She's living The old days, brother, the old days. From the backseat of the car is where you found the G-spot. I don't know. These things crack me up, guys. Spending your time with me and listening. I hope they made you laugh or smile or anything. Giggle. Or, you know, bitch goblet. Or whatever. But they kill me. I just think they're hilarious. So, anyway, that's going to be it for today. If you did like it, please smash the like button. As always, please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, guys, keep vibing. Love ya. Bye.